Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are continuing with my archaeologist's guide to Minecraft. We are still in our little hidey hole from last time, and today my goal is to get a bed. I want to get a bed so that I can sleep. So we're going to be talking about beds from an archaeological perspective. We're going to be talking about beds in Minecraft, and hopefully we find either some sheep or a village. The village would be cool. I'd rather find a village than some sheep, although sheep are excellent, but there's a lot more to talk about with a village. But really, I just want a bed. I want a bed. Is that too much to ask? I just want a bed. So let's get started. Let's get out of our hidey hole here. Look at this gorgeous view. This is actually a really nice spot. It's definitely one to keep in mind because there's a part of me that wants to just settle here because it looks so pretty. Like, that just looks, look at how pretty that is. I can't get over how pretty it is. Now, beds in Minecraft are actually really interesting because the recipe for beds and the kind of bed you make is not actually the type of bed that was the most common throughout human history. Early beds were actually made with bundles of grass, straw, animal skins, or other plant materials. And actually, our earliest preserved grass bedding dates to at least 200,000 years ago. Many ancient cultures, including the Egyptians, had raised beds as early as 3,400 BC, and these were often made of stone, and sometimes, in wealthier homes, made of metal, glazed quartz, or even gilded in gold. Beds were also used in graves or funerary contexts in ancient Egypt, and those beds would have been made with more expensive materials. But even in ancient societies that had raised beds, many people in those societies still largely slept on mattresses of straw or other plant matter that was placed either on the floor or on top of a woven mat that was on the floor. Most people didn't really have raised platform beds. So it'd be really cool if Minecraft incorporated something where if you harvest enough grass with like a stone scythe or something, you could make a mattress that works the same as a bed, just to give a few more options for sleeping. Now, lots of mods do let you craft a sleeping bag or bedroll, but those often also require either leather or wool. I actually have yet to see a bed or bed-related recipe in either vanilla Minecraft or a mod that uses plant materials or feathers, which have arguably been a much more common type of bedding for most of human history, and both feathers and cotton were still the primary bedding types used by common folk well into the early 1900s. Even today, mattresses meant either for a bed frame or for sleeping on the floor are often filled with cotton, and not necessarily wool. None of that means that the recipe for a bed in Minecraft is wrong, just that it's a recipe for a very specific style of bed, a raised bed with a mattress stuffed with wool and bedding made of wool as well. So it'd just be really interesting to see more bed recipes in Minecraft that allow for a bit more variety and incorporate things like grass or cotton or feathers as bedding types too. And now for a small montage of all of the animals I found before I found even one sheep. I hear a chicken. Hello, chicken. I'm gonna collect this egg. I like to collect eggs as and when we find them just because they give the possibility for more chickens and it's always nice to have. I'm still not seeing a village. Look at this landscape though. It's so pretty. Oh, it's a polar bear. I don't think I've ever seen a polar bear. Please, oh no, please don't attack me. I'm just gonna move. I've never seen a polar bear in Minecraft. That's so cool. Well, okay, that's not entirely true. I've never seen a polar bear, like, in the mountains in Minecraft. I always see them in the ice spikes in the oceans, but I've never seen them just hanging out in the mountains, so that's cool. I have never seen Minecraft rabbits just hanging out on a hillside. That's wild. I personally can't quite believe that I found a polar bear before I found even a single sheep. But anyway, we found sheep, so now back to beds. I didn't actually find a village anywhere nearby, but I did decide that it would probably be best, since we found some sheep, to come back to this spot here, because this is just gorgeous, and I really, really like this landscape, and I really want to turn it into something. So since we have landed wherever it is we are, and we can't find any people nearby, I think it makes sense that we would start to form our own little camp. So we've got a bed, we've got a furnace, we've got a crafting table. There are lots of trees around, so I can start to make chests and store my goods there, and I can start to build a little bit of a home for myself. So that's what I'm gonna do. I think I'm gonna, for now, I'm gonna store things in the little hidey hole just because it's here and it's already carved out, but we'll get working on a little bit of a house situation or maybe even a little hut situation. But since we found a bed already in this episode, and I like to keep these episodes a bit short and sweet, I think we're gonna end the episode there. If you enjoyed the episode, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe down below. And if you would like to, hit that notification bell so that you can be among the first to know when I release a new Archaeologist's Guide episode. That's all from me for today. Thank you all for tuning in, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye! Thank you.